Welcome to the Ambassador Cybersecurity Safeguards Badge. My name is Sarah and I'm an Ambassador Girl Scout from the Girl Scouts of Historic Georgia Council. I'm super excited to be teaching you guys today from around the country and possibly around the world. So I'm entering college as a freshman this fall and I'm going to be studying cybersecurity. So I'm really excited about this because this is kind of my thing. So this badge is the second of three cybersecurity badges for ambassadors focusing on identifying data vulnerabilities in your everyday life and how to protect yourself. This will take about 20 to 30 minutes and you're gonna need a sticky note, a highlighter, and a pen. So, to get started, where were you yesterday? What did you do? Did you post a picture of your new puppy on social media? Did you go to a friend's house with Google Maps helping you get there? Data vulnerabilities are everywhere and can come from simple things like sharing your phone password, even if it's just to your best friend, losing your driver's license because you know that has your address on it, or tossing a boarding pass in the airport trash can. Take out your sticky notes and start marking down all the times you could have been vulnerable to a data attack. How vulnerable do you think you are? You should rate from 1 to 10 on the sticky note, with 10 being totally unsafe to 1 being fine. I did this too, and so my first is I posted a picture of my robotics team at the state championship. I let a stranger follow me on Instagram, and I left my computer open and logged into my school email while I was at the library. This, posting a picture of my team at the championship, that's a one or a two. It's not very dangerous. Letting a stranger follow you on Instagram, pretty bad plan, I'd rate that a 7 or an 8. And leaving your computer open and logged into your school email at the library is really a 10. That's super bad. You shouldn't do that. So, taking the right steps to secure your data is really important since there's so much about you out all the time. You know how to keep yourself healthy with personal hygiene. You brush your teeth, you shower every day, you brush your hair. It's also important to keep up your cyber hygiene. What is cyber hygiene? Well, it's what keeps your computer running healthy and awesome like you. So it's things like updating your computer software. Yes, even if it takes a million years, it's really important. Because the actual OS or operating system, like Windows or Mac OS, what your computer runs on, can be exploited by hackers. So when the smart people over at Microsoft and Apple see their systems have been compromised, they create what's called a patch, or a piece of code that covers up the vulnerability that hackers can get into and hurt all of their computers. And then they rely on you to update your computer and deploy the patch into your computer. So you should also back up all of your data onto an external hard drive or a USB stick. In the event of a computer's total failure, you still have all your data. If you don't have access to these things, though, you can use plenty of free online things like Google Drive to save all of your data. Watch what you post and who can see it. Private accounts are always ideal. Though public accounts get you more Instagram clout and followers, you don't know who the people are that are following you or why they're following you. On a crazy worst case scenario, they could use your pictures in a huge identity fraud scheme. You also need to change your passwords. Additionally, though it is far more difficult, you should have different passwords for every single account. If you don't, that makes it easier for hackers to get all of your information. Since it's so common to have one password across the board, take for example a hacked email address. When the hacker gets into your email, they will go through the list of emails that you have and find accounts that you're signed up for on that email address. If they see, for example, your bank account, the first password they're going to try is the one they got into your email with, because, again, it's so common to have the same password for everything. In a situation like that, you just handed your debit card over to some random guy in Malaysia, and that's not really ideal. In the same vein, it's dangerous to save your credit card information on the actual shopping website like Target or Amazon. If they get access to your Target or Amazon account but don't have your credit card, it doesn't matter because it's saved and they get anything they want and free shipping, all thanks to you. So take all those sticky notes now and list everything you do in a typical day, both online and offline. Put them up on a wall in chronological order and highlight any activity that might result in a data attack. So I've done that. When looking at which sticky notes to buy, you should ask yourself questions like, when I took the trash out, did I shred the mail that had my parents' bank information on it? When I video chatted with my friends about the history project, did I turn my webcam off after? Before I bought those gift cards my friends so desperately emailed me about, Did I call and make sure it was really her instead of a phishing scheme? Take 10 minutes and think about how you can better safeguard your movements, both online and off. Write any solutions on the appropriate flag sticky note. I did that. You should implement these into your lives starting as soon as possible so that you can be safer. Mine is, I woke up and brushed my teeth. No technology involved there. I don't think my toothbrush has any chips in it. I checked the weather on my Samsung smart fridge, which I don't have, but would be super cool to have, and told Alexa to add milk to the grocery list. I'd say that's a little unsafe because Alexas are vulnerable devices. I played an online game with my sister and some online friends. Though we think we trust them, we have no proof that they are who they say they are, so I would be careful with that. I video called my boyfriend while I made lunch. As long as I use a secure video chat function, should be fine. I applied for scholarships all afternoon. I did the dishes and cleaned my room because my mom told me I had to. I ate dinner with my family, no phones allowed, and then I watched a movie on Netflix and read an ebook. So most of your activities during the day are probably gonna be safe, but for those that aren't, what are you gonna do about them? So for my changes, I put, use a physical grocery list or one that isn't accessible from anyone in the world. And to not give any personal information that isn't required with online friends. So before I go, there's a few more things you should probably know. Technology has become an essential part of our modern lives. It keeps us connected, offers us convenient ways to do tasks, and serves as a vast source of information. However, the more we use technology, the more vulnerable we become to our personal data being exposed. A data vulnerability is any weakness that leaves your data open to a cyber attack, and this may come from offline as well as online. In this activity, you experience how even everyday activities can expose you to personal data attacks. In real life, there are steps that you can take to protect your personal data. For example, you can turn off location services on social media. Be careful not to post pictures revealing your name, location, school name, or address. Keep virus protection and firewalls on at all times. Keep software updated. Update your passwords often. Keep apps updated. Disable your webcam, shred all papers with personal data, and keep your laptop and phone safe and password protected. Remember, if it's convenient, it's probably not secure. Take the extra time to safeguard your data. It's worth it in the end. So take what you learned today. Was any of it surprising, or were you already a cybersecurity whiz that knew everything? What can you share with your friends and family to keep them safe as well? What do you want to learn more about? Step 5 of this badge is to create a cyber hygiene campaign. It might seem daunting at first, but really it's just as simple as telling your family and friends how to stay safe and what cyber hygiene is as well. If this was super cool to you like it is to me, you can go ahead and try the Cybersecurity Investigator badge along with plenty of others on Girl Scouts at Home. You can explore GirlScouts.org for a lot of other awesome activities or buy some new Girl Scout swag on the Girl Scout shop. Thank you guys so much for trying this activity today, and I hope it was awesome.